high called series.
So what is the sixth system? Breathing system. Or it can be also called as respiratory system. So breathing or respiratory. So breathing system. So this is the sixth one. So children, what is breathing? Already you have learnt about in previous classes that every living organism, that is plants, animals, all the living organisms needs oxygen for their survival. So that's why they will breathe air for their survival. So if they do not breathe air, they will be dead. So that's why every living organisms needs oxygen for their survival. But different animals will breathe through different organs. So all the living animals or all living organisms does not breathe with the same type of organs. For example, most of the animals, that means most of the animals and all the human beings will breathe air with the help of the nose. So the important part of the breathing system is nose. And what is the second part is lungs. So children, so these are the main parts in the breathing system. So nose, and also there is another part which is called windpipe. So windpipe, and the third one is lungs. Children, these are the three parts present in breathing system. So the first one is nose. So all the living organism, that means most of the animals including human beings, will breathe air with the help of their nose. So but whereas some animals like fishes does not have nose. They will breathe through their special organs called gills. And some animals like frog and earthworm will breathe air through their skin. So in this way, different animals will breathe through different organs. So most of the animals and including human beings breathe oxygen through their nose. So here the nose contains some small hair like structures. So these hairs present in the nose will trap the dust and the germs present in the air. So children, so you will breathe air with the help of our nose, and the nose will have hairs. So what are the functions of the hair? So those hair which are present in our nose will trap the dust. So our air contains so many dust and germs. So if that dust and germs will, if the dust and germs go directly into our body, it will cause us a lot of diseases. So that's why, so our nose contains some hairs. So the hair present in the nose will trap the dust and germs present in our body. That means the hairs act as a like purifiers. So the hair present in the nose acts as a purifiers. They will purify the air coming into our lungs. Next, from the nose, the breathed air, the inhaled air will reach lungs through the windpipe. So from the nose, so where does the air goes? So from the nose, the inhaled air will go into the lungs through the windpipe. So there are two types of pipes in our body. So for the first one is food pipe, already discussed in our digestive system. And what is the second pipe? The second pipe is windpipe. So this windpipe helps in carrying the oxygen from the nose into the lungs. Then the air will enter into the lungs. In the lungs, it will absorb the oxygen present in the air and it will send that oxygen to the blood. So what does lungs do? The lungs will absorb oxygen from the inhaled air. The air contains so many gases: oxygen, hydrogen, nitrogen, helium. So air contains so many gases, but our body requires only one gas, that is oxygen. So children, what is this? Oxygen, this is a gas which is required to every living being for its survival. So that's why when the air is inhaled or when the air is entered into lungs, the lungs will absorb the oxygen present in the air and the absorbed oxygen will be sent to the blood. The blood will absorb the oxygen present in the lungs and carry that oxygen to every part, to every body cell of the our body. So in the presence of this oxygen and food, they will produce energy. So oxygen should require to burn the food. So children, every body part get energy. How the body part gets energy? So with the help of the food and the oxygen. So what does oxygen do? Here the oxygen burns the food and then there will be released some energy. And those energy will be helpful to every part of our body. So by using that energy only, it will do so many activities. So during this process, of burning food, a gas, another gas also will be released. That another gas which is released during burning of the food is carbon dioxide. So children, what is that gas? So carbon dioxide. So this is also another gas. So this is the name of another gas, that is carbon dioxide. This gas will also be present in our. So during the process of burning food by using oxygen, a gas named carbon dioxide will be released at each cell inside our body. And this is a waste gas and this gas does not require to our human body. So that's why the blood again carries away this carbon dioxide to the lungs. So children, do you understand? Here lungs sends the oxygen to the blood and blood again carries away the carbon dioxide to the lungs. So from lungs, the carbon dioxide will reach its nose to the windpipe and finally the carbon dioxide will come out from our nose. So that means we will breathe in oxygen, we will breathe out carbon dioxide. So this is the breathing system, children. So in this way, we can breathe in and breathe out. We will breathe in oxygen, we will breathe out carbon dioxide. So here, carbon dioxide is a waste gas which is produced inside our body at each cell during the process of burning food by using oxygen. So this is about breathing system. Now let us go to next system in this in our body. Children, the next system is reproductive system. Children, do you know what is about reproduction? Already we have learnt in previous classes, that is in 4th class and 3rd class, you have learnt what is the reproduction. So every living organism, all living organisms like plants and animals will give birth to new babies which are looking similar to them. So all living beings gave birth. All living beings gave birth or they produce a younger ones. Are small babies which are looking similar to each other, which are looking similar to their parents. So this process of producing or this process of giving birth to the babies which are looking similar to their parents is called reproduction. So children, do you understand what is reproduction? So reproduction means the process of giving birth to the small babies which are looking similar to their parents. Children, so where do you, how do your parents gave birth to you? Your parents gave birth to you and you are looking similar in some way to your parents. So this process of producing new babies or small babies which are looking similar to their parents is called reproduction. So all living organisms, each and every living organism will able to reproduce their babies. Because of this reproduction only, they are continued to live on this earth. and they are able to continue their race without to become extinct. So if there is no reproduction, or if the living organisms does not give birth to their new babies, then their race will be ends and they does not continue to live on this earth and their race will become extinct. So all living organisms will reproduce their younger ones, and those will reproduce their younger ones in the same way. They will multiply their numbers and they will remain on this earth for so many years. So as to prevent from the extinct. So now, but children, so different organs will reproduce, different animals will reproduce through different ways. All the animals, all the living organisms does not reproduce in a similar way. So for example, if you take some animals, like cats and dogs, cows and tigers, lions, examples. So for example, if you take cats, dogs, cows, tigers, so all these animals give birth directly to the babies. So they give birth directly to the babies. So but whereas some animals like fish and some birds, and if you take snakes, some snakes, especially if you take some snakes, so these animals will produce eggs and they will hatch these eggs, and after some days these eggs will produce babies. So in this way, children, all the living organisms does not reproduce in the similar way. Some animals give birth directly to the babies, and some animals produce eggs, that means they will lay eggs and they will hatch the eggs. After some days the eggs will convert into babies. For example, if you take hen, so some of people will grow hens in our houses. Those hens will lay eggs and they will hatch the eggs, and after some days the eggs will reproduce smaller babies. So this is about reproduction, and because of this reproduction only, every race of the animals are continue to living in this the earth from ancient times. So if there is no reproduction, then they does not continue to live on the earth and they will become extinct. So this is about reproductive system. So next, go to another system, that is excretory system. So children, see the last system. So what is the last system? Excretory system. So children, excretory means, what is the meaning of the word excretory? Excretory means releasing out. That means sending out. So that system is called excretory system. So what are the main parts in the excretory system? So the main parts in the excretory system is kidneys and skin. So these are the some main parts in the excretory system, kidneys and skin. So these are the some main parts. So what does the kidneys do and what does the skin do? So what are the functions of the kidneys and what are the functions of the skin? So children, already we have discussed in the digestive system, that is the food which is digested will be absorbed by the small intestines, and the food which is undigested will be sent to large intestine. So that food which is undigested is called a waste food. So that waste food will be sent to anus, and from anus it will be come out from our body. So that is called, so the process of sending out the waste food which is present in our body is called excretion. So excretion means the waste materials, the process of sending out of waste materials present in our body. Waste materials means it may be waste food or waste water or excess water or excess salts, whichever may be, the waste materials present in our body will be sent out through some organs. So, the process of sending out these waste materials which are present in our body is called excretion, and that system is called excretion system, and the parts which excrete the waste material from our body are called, one is kidney and another one is skin. So children, what are kidneys? Where does the kidneys lie in our body? So do you know the pictures of kidneys in your textbooks or in the TVs? So where does the kidneys rise and what is the shape of the kidneys? So the kidneys lies at our back on each side of the spine. So children, so spine means spinal cord. So they will lies at our back at each side of the spine. So that means they will exactly lie above our waist at each side of the spinal cord at our back. And what is the shape of the kidneys? So the kidneys will be look like the shape of beans. So children, beans, do you ever eat the vegetable beans? So the beans has some seeds which are looking in this shape. So kidneys also in the shape of beans. And what is the size of kidneys? So these are the kidneys. How many kidneys are there in our body? So children, there will be a pair of kidneys. There will be a pair of kidneys. That means two kidneys will be present in our body at our backside and at each side of the spine. Next, so these are called kidneys, and the wonderful and amazing point about kidneys is if one of the kidneys fail, then the second one remains continues to function. So that's why the living organisms, especially humans, can live even if one kidney is failed. He can live sometimes up to some years with one kidney. So this is about kidneys. So these kidneys will purify the blood. So children, what does the kidneys do? The kidneys will purify the blood. So here the blood carries the food and oxygen to each and every cell present in our body. And there the food and oxygen will take place the chemical reaction, and they will produce some waste gases like carbon dioxide and will produce some waste materials. And the waste materials present in our blood will be purified by the kidneys. So kidneys are the purifiers of our body. So children, just like water purifiers in our houses. So everyone in our houses keeps water purifier. They will purify the germs and bacteria present in our on the water. In the same way, so the kidneys will act as purifiers of our blood. And it will purify the blood, and the waste materials present in the blood will be sent out in the form of urine. So the waste will be sent out in the form of urine, and it will come out in the form of urine. And next, what does the skin do? So here, skin is one of the largest part in our body. So we have so many parts in our body. So among all the parts, the skin is the largest part, and the surface of the skin have some nerve endings. So the skin has some nerve endings, and the skin have some small pores on its surfaces. So if you observe carefully your skin, you will observe some small pores on the surface of the skin. That small pores are called sweat glands. Sweat glands. Children, so what does this sweat glands do? So the excess water and excess salts present in our body will be sent out as a sweat through these sweat glands. So the waste water and the waste salts present in our body will be sent out in the form of sweat through these sweat glands. So skin is the important part, so which will releases out the waste materials in the form of sweat. So that's why everybody have to drink at least 6 or 7 glasses of water every day, because if we don't drink water, then this waste material should not be released out, then it will be remained in our body. So if these waste materials are not sent out, if they are remained in our body, they will cause us a lot of diseases. So that's why this excretory system is another important system in our body. If it stops its functioning, then the waste materials and toxic substances will be present or will be accumulated in our body, and they will cause us a lot of diseases. That's why we have to drink more water every day. Then there will be the waste material will be sent out in the form of urine and sweat. Children, this is about excretory system and the pores, kidneys and skin. So children, these are the various systems present in our body. So all these systems works together and help each other and coordinate each other, and it helps our body to perform our regular activities. So if any one of these systems fails, then we cannot do our activities, we cannot do our regular activities. So that's why, so this is about different types of systems. Then up to now we have discussed various types of systems present in our body and the various types of parts present in each system and the functions of each system in our body. Now the next topic in this lesson is sense organs. Children, you have already learnt about sense organs and what are the sense organs and what are the senses. We have learnt in the smaller classes, previous classes. Again, we will remember, because we will recall about each sense organ and function of each sense organ and how we have to take care about each sense organ. So children, so what are the sense organs? So what are sense organs? So there are mainly 5 sense organs. So the organs by which we are able to sense the about our surroundings are called sense organs. So because of these sense organs, we are able to make aware of the surroundings. So aware of the surrounding means, so what are the different things, what are the various objects present in our surroundings, and what is their shape, color and sizes, and what are their different sounds producing in our surroundings. So in this way, we are able to make aware of about these surroundings. So these organs are called sense organs. So there are how many sense organs, children? Yes, there are 5 sense organs. The first one is eyes. So eyes, and second one ears, and third one nose, and fourth one teeth or tongue, and fifth sense organ is skin. So children, these are the 5 sense organs: eyes, ears, nose, tongue and skin. So these are the 5 sense organs. By using these 5 sense organs, we are able to make aware of the surroundings. So various type of objects, various types of things present in our surroundings, and various types of sounds produced in our surroundings, and various types of smells in our surroundings. So that's why these sense organs are called as windows. So these sense organs are called as windows to outer world and the brain. So these are the act as windows to the brain and outer world. So that's why these are called windows. And by using these sense organs, for example, the first one is eyes, ears, nose, tongue and skin. So these sense organs will receive information about the various things in our surroundings, and this received information will be sent to the brain through the nerves. And from the brain, again, it will resend the information to the sense organs. Then only we are able to see, we are able to hear, and we are able to smell. So that's why these sense organs act as like windows between our brain and outer world. So if there are no sense organs, that means if there are no windows, then what will happen? So if there are no windows and doors to our houses, what will happen? We cannot go outside and we cannot see and we cannot know what is happening outside, and all will be in the darkness. So in the same way, if there are no windows in our body, that means if there are no sense organs in our human body, then there will be nothing and we cannot aware about surroundings, there will be darkness and the brain stops working. So that's why the sense organs are very, very important, and we should take care about each sense organs, because these are very important to our human body. Because of these sense organs, we will perform different activities and we are making aware about the surroundings. So let us discuss in detail about each sense organ. So let us discuss the first one, that is eyes. So children, so let us discuss each one. So the first one is eyes. The first sense organ is eyes, and it is called as the important sense organ among five sense organs. So this eyes is called as the important sense organ among all the five sense organs. So what does eyes function? What are the functions of the eyes? Here, by using our eyes, we are able to see and we are able to observe different types of objects and various types of things in our surroundings. That's why, what is the function of the eyes? To see or to observe. So this is the function of the eyes. So we can observe the different things, and we can observe the size, their shape and their colors. And the information will be sent to the brain from the eyes with the help of nerves. So this is about nerves. So children, how many eyes we have? We have two eyes. So these are called eyes. Our eyes, there are a pair of eyes. And what are the various parts of the eyes? So if we take the outer part of the eye, there will be eyebrows. So children, eyebrows. And what are the outer parts of the eyes? So another outer part of the eyes is eyelashes. Eyelashes. And another one is eyelids. Another one is eyelids. So these are the some outer parts of our eye. So what does eyebrows do? The eyebrows will prevent the sweat to running into our eye. So if you do a lot of work daily, then our body will produce sweat. And if the sweat is a waste material and it contains some salts, impure salts, if that sweat will enter into our eye, then it will cause some irritation and it will cause some damage to the eye. So that's why, what is the function of these eyebrows? Children, so these eyebrows does not enter the sweat to the eye. So these eyebrows prevent the sweat to enter the eye. Next, what is the function of eyelashes? So eyelashes will protect our eyes from the dirt. So our air contains a lot of dust and dirt and germs in our eye. And these eyelashes will protect the dirt to enter the eyes. Next, what are the eyelids? So these eyelids will protect our eyes from outer injuries or outer injuries. So children, what does the eyelids do? So it protects from outer injuries. Protects from outer injuries. So this is the function of eyelids, and also these eyelids will act as a windows to our eyes. And if there is a too much of light, then it will prevent our eyes from too much light just by closing the eyes. So that's why these eyelids will protect our eyes from outer injuries and from too much of light. And eyelids will always keeps our eyes very moist. So it will keeps the moisture of the eyeballs. So children, so this is about eyes, and these are the some outer parts of the eyes, and these are the functions of the eyes. So that's why this is one of the important sense organ, and we have to take care about the eyes. So what are the precautionary measures? So what case we have to take about eyes is,
The first one is, so what care we have to take is, the first one is,
wash your eyes regularly with cold water.
So wash your eyes regularly with cold water. Wash your eyes. Children,
so we will do and we will play a lot of games and we will do a lot of works daily from early morning to till we go to sleep. And there will be a lot of dirt and germs will stick to eyelashes. And that's why we have to wash our eyes regularly with cold water.
Next, second one is,
do not work in dim light.
So children, so this is the important precaution. So while we are studying or any doing working, so do not, should not do any work in the dim light. So do not work in dim light. So children,
care should be taken while we are doing any work like reading or writing or anything. So while we are doing any work, we should take care that there should be some sufficient light. So if there is no sufficient light and if you do the works in the dim light, then it will cause damage to our eyes and it will cause stress and strain to our eyes and that leads to some eye defects. So that's why this is the one of the important precautionary measure. So don't read in dim light and don't any work, do not do any work in that dim light. And next, the third one is, so do not watch TVs or do not watch mobiles sitting nearer to it, and also do not watch TVs for longer times. So the third one is, do not watch TVs and do not watch your mobiles or laptops or computers, anyone. So do not watch them by sitting near to them. We have to keep some distance between eyes and our TVs or laptops or mobiles. So we have to keep some distance while watching TVs, laptops or computers. So the otherwise the radiation coming from the monitors of the TVs or laptops, it will damage our eye because it is a sensitive organ in our body. Eyes are the sensitive organs of our body and they cannot bear too much of light and too much of radiation. And do not watch TVs or laptops or computers for longer time. So children, so remember these points and follow these precautionary measures and protect your eyes. Then your eyes will be remain in good condition. Otherwise, it will lead to some diseases and eye defects. So this is about eyes. Next, the next sense organ is ears. So the next sense organ is children, ears. How many ears we have? Children, we have 2 ears. So how they are located? So they are located at each side of our head. So these are called ears. So what do we do with our ears? So we do hearing. So by using ears, we will hear. So to hear. So what is the sense we can feel with our ears is to hear. We will hear different types of sounds produced in surroundings. That means different types of sounds produced by birds and sounds produced by animals, sounds produced by vehicles every day in our surroundings. And by using our ears, we can identify some objects just by listening to their sounds produced from them. And we can identify some objects. We can identify some vehicles just by listening the sounds coming from them. And without seeing them, we can identify the objects or animals and also some vehicles by just listening to the sounds produced from them. So in this way, so ears are very helpful to make aware of some objects and things in our surroundings. So children, what are the main parts of our ears? So there are 3 main parts in our ear. That is, the first one is outer ear, and the second one is middle ear, and the third part is inner ear. Children, these are the 3 parts present in our ears. So the first one is outer ear. Outer ear means the part of the ear which is seen outside of our body is called outer ear. So charan, so look at this. So all this part is called outer ear because this part is present outside and we are able to see with our eyes. So the part of the ear which can be seen with our eyes and which is present outside the body is called outer ear. And what does the outer ear contains? So this is a very broad and this receives the different types of sounds produced in the surroundings. That means this outer ear acts like antenna. So just like antenna, so for a TV or a radio or a remote, what does the antenna do? It will receives different types of waves and different types of communications. In this way, this outer ear will act as antenna and it will receive different types of sounds which are produced in outer surroundings. And it will send that sounds into the ear. So this outer ear receives the different types of sounds and send that sounds into the middle ear. Next, the sound which enter into the middle ear. So the middle ear will contains a thin layer or a thin membrane called eardrum. So children, so when the sounds enter the middle ear, so these sounds will vibrate this thin layer or thin membrane called eardrum. This eardrum will vibrate when the sounds enter our ear. And these vibrations will be sent to the inner ear. So what does inner ear contains? The inner ear contains some types of bones which are in different shapes. These bones and also some liquid is present in the inner ear. These bones and liquid together makes these sounds amplified. And these amplified sounds will be sent to brain with the help of nerves. So children, so this is ears and the various parts present in ear. So that's why we should take care about ears. Otherwise, the ears will be damaged and we cannot hear any sound. Then there will be a communication gap between with others. So that's why we will take care also about ears. What we have to take care precautionary one is, that is, the first one is, so avoid louder voices or loud sounds. So avoid loud sounds. So children, do not hear loud sounds, especially at the time of Diwali, crackers will be burnt and they will produce a loud sound. So during that time, if there is any loud sound, we should close our ears with our hands. So if we hear that loud sounds, that loud sounds will cause damage to eardrum. If the eardrum will be damaged, then we cannot hear any sounds. That's why avoid loud sounds. Next, another precautionary measure is, so do not clean your ears with matchsticks or, so do not clean your ears with matchsticks or hairpins. So children, don't clean your ears with matchsticks and hairpins. So because, so if you clean your ears with matchsticks or hairpins or needles, so they will cause damage to eardrum. So it will, there will be become a hole, there will make a hole to eardrum and they will damage the eardrum. If the eardrum is damaged, then we cannot able to hear any sound. So do not clean your ears with the matchsticks and hairpins. And next, another one is, so what we have to use to clean our ears? So use buds to clean our ears. So use buds, that is earbuds, to clean our ears. So children, so these are some precautionary measures to take care about ears. Now go to third sense organ. We will discuss about the third sense organ, nose.